your faces. It's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
Says, welcome to Family Feud, the show where answering some very simple questions can win you $10,000 and maybe even a brand new car. Time to meet our families. First up, would you please welcome back our carryover champs who are here with us for their third night in a row from WA. It's the Weatherburn family. Remind Australia who's on board this team of yours.
I have my lovely nieces, Leng, May and Lena.
Please make them feel welcome. And also from Victoria tonight, let's hear it for the Midler family. Hey, how are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Would you mind introducing us to your team?
Absolutely. This is my dad, Saul, my sister, Lauren and my mum, Helen.
Great to have you guys with us. Welcome along. Righto, team captains, let's do it. Round one. One hand on the table, one hand behind your back. Let's go. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Give a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch. Daniel.
They carry their broomstick around.
Yeah, it would be a fair giveaway.
Yeah.
Andrew.
Witch's hat.
She has a witch's hat. Ooh. Pass or play? So fast, you guys are flying. How are you, Saul?
Very good.
What do you do?
I'm a consultant and I look after business continuity management.
Business continuity management. What on earth does that mean?
It's about disaster management. How to be ready to manage a disaster and get back going again the next day.
So you're the man who keeps everything going when it turns into a crisis.
Yes.
You're the go-to guy.
The go-to.
The Mr. Fix-It.
That's it.
You're a handy bloke to have on the team.
Thank you.
Give me a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch.
When I think witch, I think black cat.
Black cat. Great job. How are you, Lauren?
I'm good.
Give me a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch, Lauren.
She's got a wand.
If you're a wand, do it.
Yeah.
First strike. Oh. No need to stress. How are you, Helen?
Good, thanks, Grant.
Good to see you. Was
Thank
it your
you.
Idea to come on the show?
No, it was Lauren's.
Was it really? How come you guys then aren't up this end as captains?
Slow brain, too old. They shunted me up
here. You're just here for the fun ride.
Yeah, that's it.
Let's do it, Helen. Give me a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch.
And this is why they shunted me up the end. I'm going with she's stirring a cauldron.
Yeah, probably be a good one. Nice. So this is your chance to tell me the reason why you're captain is because you're so awesome.
Alrighty. I reckon because they have a large nose or with boils on it.
What about large nose? So you're a business continuity consultant who loves the Thunderbirds. Do you really, Sol?
Yes, I do.
A lot?
A lot, yeah. Grant, yes.
Got the little collectibles?
Yes, yes.
Walk around the house going like this a lot?
Where nobody's looking.
What do you love about it exactly?
Look, at the time, just the futurism of it and the technology behind it.
Of puppets on strings.
What? Oh. He doesn't know
the puppets on strings.
No, they're real.
The flying spaceships you're talking about and the fact that rockets come out of the pool.
Yeah.
It's awesome, isn't it?
They bleed, you know, they sweat.
And it's still on television these days. How awesome is that?
Brilliant.
Right. Give me a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch.
Because they laugh funny.
Because they...
You know, that cackle.
So give us an example.
that was creepy. Let's have a look.
Strike two. Weatherburns could steal from you here, Loz. This is your idea. Let's do this.
Yeah.
Give me a reason you might suspect someone's a witch.
If she's got a wart.
Yeah. Another hot word. Yes! Two left, Helen. We're going good. So if you were to suspect someone's a witch, what would give it away?
She might be casting some spells.
She might be. Hopefully good ones.
Hopefully.
Nice. Wow. Midler's cracking opening game here. You're one away from a clean sweep. What's number six, Daniel? Give me a reason you may suspect someone to be a witch.
Green skin.
Show me green skin.
Green skin.
Whoa! The Midler's do it! Out of the box, grabbing 80 solid points in a clean sweep. Keep that up, Midler's, and you know what? And play for 5 nights just like that. You'll be taking home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. Now, the new Outlander sets the benchmark with safety features including active traction control, reverse parking camera and sensors, paddle shift, gear changing, and Mitsubishi's multi-communication system. And for everybody playing along at home who want the top answer to this question, see how you go. Name something women get excited about. We'll compare answers when we come back right here on Family Feud. Don't go anywhere. Are competing for the chance to win $10,000, and so far the Midler's playing superbly, clean sweep in the opening game and off to a barnstorming start with 80 points. And before the break I asked, name something women get excited about, and the answer was
shoes.
Did you get it? Nice work if you did. Righto, Ling, Saul, let's play the feud.
My hands are really sweaty.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name a reason you'd take a train rather than a plane to your holiday destination.
It costs less.
It's cheaper. Close to the top, Saul.
Scenery is nicer.
Good answer. Let's see if it's there. Pass or play? Now, name a reason you'd take a train rather than a plane to your holiday destination.
Fear of flying.
Ah, love that. That was a nice cheer, nice supportive cheer. Your victory celebrations have somewhat been the best so far in the series. Loving that. Name a reason you'd take a train rather than a plane to your holiday destination.
To avoid the airport.
Okay, cool. Nice. Andrew?
Great.
Holidays, you like to travel?
I do a bit, yes. Yeah? Yes.
Overseas, domestically?
A bit of both.
Yeah.
Love going with the family.
Yeah, yes. Taking them and seeing the world. And
that's right.
Opening their eyes to new things.
Yes.
Would you take a train or a plane?
I'd take a train.
Mm, why?
There's a little bit more leg room.
More leg room?
Yes.
That was a good answer, though. Although not really an issue for me. Why is that funny? I have feelings too, you know. Name a reason you'd take a train rather than a plane to your holiday destination?
Because that's the only option.
Because it's the only way to get there. That's two strikes, I'm afraid. The Midler's could steal here. Righto, mate.
No baggage limit. Weight limit.
You can just load up your clothes. That's three strikes, I'm afraid. Midler's. Helen, what would you say?
Because it's fun.
Lauren.
You can go with friends.
Saul.
More spacious.
You're just making that cabin up as you go?
Yeah.
Good. Daniel.
I reckon I'm going to go with Mum and say just because it's more fun, more interesting.
Just more fun and more interesting. Let's see if we get you some points and another steal. No, it's not, so the Weatherburn's back in business. Number 8. Avoid jet lag. For the adventure. Avoid a crash. Or it's quicker, it's close. There you go. Right now, the scores are 67. So we're back in the game and it's close. The Midlers, though, have at the moment 80 points. But right now, double points time for this next question. So, May, Lauren, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 5 answers are on the board.
What's something a husband might talk about that wives pretend to be interested in? Lauren?
Sport.
Sport.
Pass or play? What's something a husband might talk about that wives pretend to be interested in?
I was going to have to go with something particularly pertinent to my husband and say science fiction movies.
Let's see if it's on the board. No, it's not, I'm afraid. Daniel?
Tools or hardware.
Yeah.
Tools.
Yeah.
Power tools.
Yeah.
Love it.
That's so... Two strikes down. Now the Weatherburns could steal.
Saul. This has got to be close to your heart, surely.
Ooh.
For a man who likes the Thunderbirds, what's something a husband might talk about that wives pretend to be interested in?
Business.
Yeah. I like where you're going with that.
Well done.
Lauren?
All right. Beer.
Just talk for hours about beer.
Yep.
Love a golden ale. That's three strikes, I'm afraid. Weatherborns, over to you. Lena.
Cars.
May.
Cars.
Leng.
Gadgets.
Andrew, great options, but you're going with cars. Give me cars for the steal. One excitable huddle. I want to be in that huddle. Remaining answers. Football. Just life in general. Righto. The Weatherborns now have captured the lead and jumped to 211. The Midler family are on 80 right now. Look, we know you like watching Family Feud, then why not play along at home with the official Family Feud game? Simply head to 10 Play and check out the Family Feud section for all the highlights as well, the stuff that goes on behind the scenes that doesn't quite make it into the show. It's worth it. After the break, anyone can win this one. We'll play for triple points. Don't go anywhere. Midler families, they were in the lead, they're on 80, but right now the Weatherburns are on 211. It's the family gets the 300 points in this round is going to win the $10,000 potentially, and we're playing for triple points. So give me Lena, give me Helen, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Tell me something a girl might do during a dinner date that could indicate she's not going well. It's not going well. Lena.
Go to the bathroom all the time.
She might continually go to the bathroom. Not the top answer, Helen.
Check her mobile phone.
Let's see. Pass or play? You guys are going to play. Something a girl might do during a dinner date that could indicate it ain't going well.
Play with her hair?
All right. It's not going well if she's playing with her hair, you say. No. First strike. Ling.
Okay.
What's a telltale sign that the date's dying?
I do an early exit.
Just get on out.
Just
cut your losses and just say, hey, you're not worth it, I'm out. Mm-hmm. Let's have a look.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a pretty clear message. It ain't going well when she's gone. Mate.
I think I'll yawn.
Yeah, just right in their face.
I can't help it.
Great story.
I'll yawn too.
What about yawn? Yeah. Ever been on a terrible date?
There's a story in there.
Well, my first date with my boyfriend, who's now my husband, his car broke down.
Oh.
And he made me get out and push.
Oh, my goodness. Really?
Yeah.
Ow.
And then we had to get a tow truck.
Yeah.
And it dropped us back at his parents' house.
Oh.
And his dad drove me home.
Wow.
So...
this is the end to a terrible night.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. So, you're just right up your
alley.
I stuck
in there.
Yeah, you did. He was obviously worth it. Tell me something a girl might do during a dinner date that could indicate it's not going well.
text her friend?
Yeah, just start texting people. That's two strikes, so the Midlers could steal. Andrew?
It's really hard to read a woman's mind.
Don't even try, my friend.
No.
Tell me something a girl might do during a dinner date that could indicate it's not going well.
She might fall asleep.
Is this from personal experience?
No.
No?
No.
No? No. You'd certainly know, wouldn't you? If she fell asleep. That's three strikes. Midlers, your turn. Helen.
I think she'd be looking at her watch.
Lauren.
Cry.
That is a mega, well. Mega bad one. Saul.
Said she was feeling sick.
Yep. Excellent. Daniel, some great options from the family, but you're the boss here, so you can go with what you like.
I have to agree with my mum again and say she looks at a watch.
Are you... Daniel. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
Are you afraid of your mum?
Sometimes.
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 See, she's at the opposite end. Is that because
it was planned.
You want to keep her an arm's distance, but you still have to go with the answer.
Yeah, I have to, or else.
Let's go with what mum said. Yeah! Turns out a good decision for Daniel. It gets him some valuable points. Number five. Chicken head, other man. You roll your eyes. Body language. Well, with that masterstroke that Daniel just played, which was really mum's idea, it's pulled them back into the game, but it's brought us to sudden death. So, neither team has reached 300 points right now, so we have to settle this by getting our team captains to the podium, please. Best of luck to the both of you. There's only one answer on the board here and it's worth triple points. Whoever wins sudden death right now will win the game and become tonight's champion family. Best of luck. We survey 100 people and the top answer is on the board. Name something you associate with the radio. Daniel.
News.
The news. Is news the top answer? No, it's not. Andrew.
Music.
Music! Yeah! Daniel, well played, mate. Saul, Lauren, Helen.
Thanks.
Let's hear it for the Midlers. You didn't win, buddy, but you're going to go home with a gift card for $1,000 from Showcase Jewellers, your local independent jeweller. So let's hear it for the Midlers for playing beautifully and giving it a round of applause. Weatherburns, wow, let's do it. Fast money, who's in? Oh. Andrew's been dropped from the team. That's all right. We're all excited. You guys are dancing and partying. We got to see Andrew's dance moves up there at the podium for the win. Look at that. Look at him. That is a happy man who just doesn't care that people are watching. Are you ready to infect the soundproof booth? Right up. This is how many times have we had to go with this now?
This is the third time.
This is our third time for $10,000. Up top. We ready to do it?
Yes.
Confidence. Yes. Precision.
Yes.
Perfection. When we come back, we shoot for $10,000 in fast money round right here on Family Feud.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Here on the Feud, so let's see if the Weatherburns can win some cash. Now, if you and Lena get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. Lena is in our soundproof booth where you won't believe it's best and less. And she can't hear your answers right now because she's enjoying the music a little too much. I'm going to ask you five questions. I'm going to give you 20 seconds to answer. Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. And the clock starts at the end of the very first question. So, are you ready?
Yes, ready.
Okay, 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. Name an item people put out on hard rubbish day.
Beds.
Name something you find on a hamburger.
Meat.
Name something that makes a room cosy.
Fireplace.
Name something you'd find in a beach bag.
Sunscreen.
Name something you see in the sky.
Clouds.
Love it. Love it. That was pretty good. Let's go. Confident?
Yes.
I think it was a good performance. Let's see how well you went. Name an item people put out on hard rubbish day. You said
Beds, survey says. 2. A little lower than last time.
Yes.
Would you get last night 150? Name something you find on a hamburger. You said. You find meat on a hamburger. Survey says. 10.
Ooh. Jeez.
Name something that makes a room cozy. You said. A fireplace does. Survey says. Bit better. There we go. Name something you'd find in a beach bag. You said. Sunscreen. Survey says. There you go. Name something you see in the sky. You said. I see clouds in the sky. The survey says. 51 comes home strong. Well done, mate. Head back to Family Feud aboard. Welcome back, Lena.
Thank you,
Brad. Ooh, gee, tough. You only need 65 to get 10,000. You guys are so easy to set off. I love it. I'm going to ask you the same 5 questions, but the second player, so you get an extra 5 seconds. Okay. Now, if you pass on a question, we'll come back if there's time. If you repeat an answer that's already there, you'll hear this sound, and I'll ask you to try again. Can we remind everybody of May's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question. Best of luck. Name an item people put out on hard rubbish day.
The couch.
Name something you find on a hamburger.
Beef.
Try again.
Tomatoes.
Name something that makes a room cozy.
Blankets.
Name something you find in a beach bag.
Towels.
Name something you see in the sky.
Planes.
Excellent performance. Come on! Let's go. Last night, you had the best opening half in Fast Money ever and the worst second half ever. So let's see if we can close the deal tonight.
Yep.
Name an item people put out on hard rubbish day. You said, we need a good start for a good result and we have a great start. Top answer. Oh. Excellent. Couch or sofa was the top answer, so we need 43 for $10,000 here. Name something you find on a hamburger. You said, tomatoes. Survey says, 13. Cheese was the top answer.
Okay.
Now it's just 30 for $10,000. What would you do with $10,000?
Spend it.
It's pretty easy, Grant. Stupid question. I'd spend it. Name something that makes a room cozy. You said. Blankets does. Survey says.
Oh, no. 2.
May had the top answer of fireplace. 28 for $10,000. Name something you find in a beach bag. You said. Towels. We need 28 or more from these final 2 for $10,000. Does this feel like a good answer?
Yeah.
It feels to me like a good answer. Is it a great answer? The survey says. At home, stick around. The project is next on 10 and join us again next time when we all play Family Feud. I'm Grant Denyer. That was a lot of fun. We'll see you next time, Australia.